Hello students, today let us continue the lesson Our Karnataka. In the previous class we have discussed about Bangalore division. Today let us learn about Mysuru division. Mysuru is another administrative division of our state. Mysuru was the capital of the Odiyar kings. Since from the ancient period Mysuru was culturally very famous. In Mysuru, there are 8 districts. In the Mysuru division, there are 8 districts. They are Mysuru, Mandya, Hasan, Chikmagaluru, Udupi, Dakshina Kannada, Chamarajanagar and Kodagu. So in that, the center of administrative division is Mysuru. Many of the rich districts of Karnataka are in this division. This division is famous for rivers, mountain ranges, forest, wild animals, coffee plantation, coals and forts. Because of these reasons, Mysuru division was one of the most famous administrative division of Karnataka state. Now, let us learn about the history of Mysuru. The history of Mysuru begins with Ganga's rule, and they made Talakadu was the capital of Ganga's. As you all know, our state Karnataka was ruled by many number of royal dynasties. In that, one of the most famous dynasty, which is called Ganga's. So Mysuru was ruled by the Ganga's. Later, Mysuru came under the rule of Cholas, Hoysalas and Vijayanagara kings. So, this Mysuru kingdom was ruled by many number of royal dynasties like Gangas, Cholas, Hoysalas, Vijayanagara kings. These kingdoms contributed lot in the field of art, architecture, literature and administration. Mysuru was under the rule of Odeyars. Odeyars ruled this Mysuru kingdom many centuries. Not only they have ruled and contributed lot for the development of Mysuru kingdom. Even after some years, this Mysuru was ruled by Hyder Ali and his son Tipu Sultan. So after the Odeyars, this Mysuru kingdom was under the rule of Hyder Ali and Tipu Sultan. These Tipu Sultan and Hyder Ali also contributed a lot for the welfare of Mysuru kingdom. So how the name Mysuru came into the existence? Mysuru is called Mahishanadu historically as well as mythologically. Mythologically means religious or cultural tradition. Okay, so Mysuru is called Mahishanadu. This Mysuru was ruled by one monster or demon who is called Mahishasura. So it was called Mahishanadu. According to the mythological stories, the goddess Parvati killed Mahishasura in the form of Chamundeshwari. So the place where Mahisha was killed became the Mysuru. The story says that this Mahishasura used to give the trouble to the people. So, goddess Parvati Devi killed Mahishasura in the form of Chamundeshwari Devi. So, the place where Mahisha was killed became Mysuru. Even today, if we go to the Mysuru, there we can see the statue of Mahishasura in front of the temple Chamundeshwari. Chamundeshwari Devi temple is in Chamundi Hill. So this is the picture shows how the goddess Parvati Devi killed the Mahishasura. Eduraya was the first ruler of Odeyar dynasty. The Odeyar dynasty was started by the Eduraya Odeyar. So after the Eduraya Odeyar, this Mysuru was ruled by Chikka Devaraya Odeyar. He was the most famous king of Mysuru kingdom. During his time, He has given importance for all the field and he supported for the welfare of the state. So after the Chikkadevaraya, the Odeyars who came to the power, they were very weak. So Hyder Ali, who was the military general, he took over the administration of Mysuru. Hyder Ali and his son Tipu Sultan ruled the Mysuru from 1761 to 1799. Tipu waged the many wars against the British and he negotiated, means he maintained a friendly relationship with the French to dethrone the British rule in India. Because French were the enemy of British. So by taking the help of the French, he wanted to control the rule of British in India. So he undertook numerous people friendly measures in the state. During the time of Tipu's rule, many pro-people welfare programs were implemented in India. So here, during the time of Hyder Ali and Tipu Sultan, they fought four important war with the British. That is called as a Anglo-Mysore War. First Anglo-Mysore War, second Anglo-Mysore War, third Anglo-Mysore War. In the year 1799, fourth Anglo-Mysore War was fought against the British by the Tipu Sultan. He fought bravely and courageously. Unfortunately, Tipu died in the war against the British. For his bravery and courage, he was popularly called as a Tiger of Mysuru. Then the British handed over the administration back to the Odeyar. After the death of Tipu Sultan, once again British handed over the administration of Mysuru to the Odeyar. Once again British took over the administration in the year 1831 due to the weak administration. When the rule of Odeyars weakened in the Mysuru, once again, this British took over the administration in the year 1831. Again in the year 1881, the administration was given back to the Odeyars. After that, among the Odeyars, Krishna Raja Odeyar was the most famous Odeyars of the Mysuru. Krishna Raja Odeyar IV. He undertook many people-friendly developmental measures in the beginning of 20th century. During the time of 20th century, this Krishna Raja Odeyar gave more importance for the welfare of the Mysuru kingdom. He has given importance for the field of education, culture, agriculture, industry, irrigation. So, the Mysuru kingdom got integrated into the Republic of India after the independence. So, after the independence means when India became an independent country, there had a big problem merging the princely states to the Indian Union. So, after the independence, this Mysuru kingdom got merged or joined or integrated into the Republic of India after the independence. So, Mysuru witnessed marvelous development under the administration of Diwan Sir M. Vishweshwaraya and Sir Mirza Ismail. Sir M. Vishweshwaraya and Sir Mirza Ismail are the two most famous Diwans under the Krishna Raja Odeyar. Here, during the time of Sir M. Vishweshwaraya and Sir Mirza Ismail, many number of industries were established and developed as a wish of Krishna Raja Odeyar IV. Even the Krishna Raja Sagara Dam was also constructed under the leadership of Sir M. Vishweshwaraya. He was the first engineer from our state, Karnataka, and his birthday is celebrated as a Engineer's Day. Like Vishweshwaraya or Sir M. Vishweshwaraya, Sir Mirza Ismail also most famous Diwan or Minister of Mysuru Odeyars. Kodagu, which was under the Mysuru kingdom, it was ruled by many dynasty. The first dynasty which ruled Kodagu, Haleri dynasty, which ruled Kodagu from 17th century, Bidanuru was the capital of Kodagu. The district of this division also have a history of being ruled by the different dynasty. Dodda Veerappa is the most famous king of this dynasty. Chikka Veeraraja was the last ruler of this dynasty, means the Haleri dynasty. who is the most famous king of the Haleri dynasty? Dodda Veerappa is the most famous king of the Haleri dynasty, and Chikka Veera Raja was the ruler or the last ruler of the Haleri dynasty, and he was a very weak. Due to his weakness, the British took advantage of this and took over the administration. Now Kodagu came under the control of British. Kodagu remained an independent state even after the independence. So after 1956, means in 1956, it got integrated into the Mysuru state. When Karnataka was integrated in the year 1956, this Kodagu also integrated into the Mysuru state in the year 1956. Keladi was another one important dynasty which was under the Mysuru kingdom. Next, Tulu Nadu. As we are all know that we are in Tulu Nadu. Udupi, Dakshina Kannada is called as a Tulu Nadu. Or the coastal area of Karnataka is called as a Tulu Nadu. Coastal Karnataka is called as a Tulu Nadu. So this Tulu Nadu also ruled by many number of royal dynasty. One of the most famous royal dynasty which ruled Tulu Nadu, that is Alupa dynasty. Alupa dynasty ruled over Tulu Nadu, that includes the present Udupi and Dakshina Kannada district from the 7th century to the 14th century. For a long period of a time, our Udupi and Dakshina Kannada was under the rule of Alupa dynasty. Udyavara, Banavasi, Huncha and Mangalapura. Mangalapura means the present Mangalore is called as a Mangalapura because there was one famous temple, Mangala Devi temple. So it was called Mangalapura, where the capitals of Alupas at a different time. So they made Udyavara, Banavasi, Huncha and Mangalapura as the capital of Alupas. Many Palegaras ruled this Tulu Nadu. The most famous Palegaras are Puttiges, Chautas, Bangavadis, Bangaru, Karkalas, Bairavaru and Kasaragodus. Kumble kings are the well-known Palegaras who ruled the Tulu Nadu in that most famous royal dynasty which ruled Tulu Nadu, that is Alupas. The coastal Karnataka was called in a different name. It was called as a Kenara by the British. British called this coastal Karnataka as a Kenara. They took over this area during the time of 1801. They divided coastal area into Uttara Kannada and Dakshina Kannada. Coastal area means we are near to the Arabian Sea, coast of Arabian Sea. So the British divided this coastal area into Uttara Kannada means north, Dakshina Kannada means south. So this is the map of Uttara Kannada district. Look at the map. There are some important taluks, that is Yellapura, Mandagodu, Sirsi, Siddhapura, Vannavara, Kumta, Ankola, etc. This is the map of Dakshina Kannada. Districts, taluks like Mangaluru, Bantwal, Beltangadi, Puttooru, Sullya are the famous taluks which are there in the Dakshina Kannada. Udupi district was created recently in the year 1997 by dividing Dakshina Kannada district. Earlier, Dakshina Kannada and Udupi was together. So it was Udupi was created in which year? It was created in the year 1997 by dividing Dakshina Kannada into Dakshina Kannada and Udupi district. So this is about the Mysuru division. I hope you all understood the famous districts of the Mysuru division, history of Mysuru division, and what are the contributions of Tipu Sultan and Odeyars for the development of Mysuru kingdom.